Now, do you see that truck now behind me? Maybe not. I cannot even see what you can see. But the point was basic. In this space, time, mind continuum. And I don't have to yell. I don't know. Maybe I do. Okay. Maybe less now. But I don't know what you can hear. I can see maybe, but I don't know what you can hear. So, I'm yelling, hey people, on the other side of space-time mind continuum. Did you hear what the message was? You can play this game of thoughts and ideas any way you like. You like entertainment, be the one. You want money, make more. It all depends what you really want to achieve in this game. And the issue is, you may don't know what you want to achieve. You think you want to get all that money, get rich, get free. You know, everybody wants to be free electron and fly anywhere you want. But do you know what happens to the wave function of a free electron? By the way, do you know how long does a free electron live? You know, if an atom, you know, you can calculate a half-time life of a carbon-12 or carbon-14 atom, right? And that is how they do this carbon dating. But what about the half-time life of an electron of that carbon atom? Do you know the solution? Did you see how I did it? It's exactly how my numbers read that. These convulsions put me in a state of mind, I would have said state of space-time mind. Really upset. Now I did it myself. Maybe he just reflected what he saw before. And that must have been my mistake, so I have to apologize in front of him, in front of everybody here. I may have said what apparently was supposed to be said, otherwise I wouldn't. Otherwise, we all would have proven that we live in a simulated reality. The reality that is coming at this point of space-time mind, we don't know exactly when. But there's no questions. They will develop those algorithms based on quantum computing or maybe even more advanced quantum genetic computing. Do I understand that in a genetic level, this operates almost like a quantum computing on a biological level, on the genetic programming stuff that they put there? Maybe they have already done it, I don't know. And I'm not going to argue with no one about it. I am just telling it to myself. That guy who is already there at the other side of that space-time mind continuum, maybe 10,000 years, our Earth years from now. I don't know. But I know he will be there, and I need to talk to him because he wants to advance, he has to reach to me. Okay? And here I'm supposed to shut up and let you to think, but I will tell you still the story just as a practice. Because I'm supposed to tell that story about a competition, computer competition that I read about roughly maybe 10 years ago. Okay, so imagine I'm working for a big international company. I come to the library at least once a week just to read something, you know, to stay abreast with new research stuff. So I'm reading a magazine, New Scientist, and they on the side talking about a competition that they had somewhere in California where the best people in the field are playing a game. It's a competition. for the best program. Originally, everybody gets the same amount of space on the server. And then, the guy who owns 100% of it wins. So now it's a semi-final. I mean, it's next, I mean, really close to the end of it, where only two left. One is NASA's team, NASA's program, okay? The other is a Russian, and I'm not pulling your leg, that's what I read there, okay? They're saying that it's a PhD student from Moscow State University, wrote a program that came at the par with NASA's team's program. One guy, a PhD student. And guess what? NASA's program is kicking his, I will say word, ass. I don't know if it's appropriate to say ass. Anyways, you understand what Mr. Russian is trying to avoid. Okay. Trying to be appropriate and find the right way to express something that could be inappropriate for other people. So, think about this. The final two programs, NASA's program put his, that other guy's PhDs, Russian PhD student's program down 5% of the server left. And guess what? It turns around because it's learned the behaviors of the other program, how that behaves, and the Russian guy wins it there. This is freaking unbelievable. All these years when I am trying to develop a simple thing to bring something which is so obviously good for many people, useful, and I cannot get through the best people in the field who are supposed to find something like that and support. Instead, они вставляют мне палки в колеса. Ты представляешь, куда такой годится, блин? Но я специально переключился, ребята, чтобы вы меня лучше понимали, а то не все знают английский язык, а обе команды должны быть примерно в равных состояниях. Поэтому 9 мая приближается, и вы понимаете, почему я с вами заговорил на этом другом языке. А те, которые не должны понять, они не поймут. Даже если они поймут каждое слово, что я скажу, они все равно не поймут, для чего все это. Там есть already advanced, super advanced, absolutely advanced. You cannot imagine even super ideal advanced computing, not computing stuff in that future in infinity. It has to be. Okay. But they will still don't understand even what, not us, avatars. You know, imagine, just imagine for a second that you are an avatar in this little game. And they train you. They train you. Who are they? Yourself. You, like not genetically programmed self, but your real self, ideal, what they say, spirit or soul or whatever, you know. That guy who is real, he's not the soul, he's real in that different dimension. Which so far what I'm describing, of course, not real at all. It's like a virtual world which will exist in the future. But it will get to the point when in that virtual world you click the boom, the button, and you can generate real world in your computer. Again, I cannot tell you how far it is. 50 years from now, no, maybe 50 light years from now. But it may have already existed, because I say there is that principle. If you cannot imagine, it already exists. So every time you imagine something good, boom, you bring to life something good, positive stuff. You imagine something bad, boom, you bring something negative. in that universal balance of unimaginable imagination. That's good enough, stupid stuff. Just wanted to put it out of my head. The goal was just to learn how to smile. Regardless of whatever I say, it's irrelevant. But maybe if I speak Russian, I'll do it better. Ребят, как сейчас, улыбка лучше или нет? Natural. Ну, сами понимаете, да, вот с такой вот программой, с такой вот головой тупой, да, как куда-то можно кому-то что-то объяснить. Я глубоко извиняюсь, что за все эти годы так и не поумнел. И продолжаю тараторить то, что, в общем-то, любому ежу понятно. И к тому же не на том языке. Но вы-то где? Сколько я уже, чуть не сказал, товарищу Маслякову не послал имейл? Сколько? Это же уму непостижимо, как говорила наша классная учительница. Я ему уже столько видео взял, которые я вот записываю с этого телевизора. Семья уже на меня смотрит не то что волком. Я даже не знаю, какой дикой собакой динго она на меня смотрит. Моя лучшая половина. И все равно ему не послал имейл. Почему? Подумали, почему за все эти годы я не послал ему, чуть не сказал, товарищу Маслякову имейл. А вот подумайте. Ответ простой. Время было не то. Не подошло то время. Это не его вина, не моя вина. Не подошло то время, что я ему не послал имейлы, которые должен был послать. Я думал тогда. Еще сейчас еще не прошло. Видишь, только сейчас заговорил по-русски. Ничего. Мы пробьемся. Сейчас фокус на 9 мая. 9 мая я должен подготовиться. Поэтому я эту камеру взял с собой. Но вы смотрите, ребята, не подведите. Это часть игры. Называется «Поможем за границей». За границей. Не за границей нам поможет, а мы поможем за границей. Потому что это борьба, которая сейчас происходит между Россией и Америкой на всех этих политических уровнях, на всех дипломатических уровнях, соревнованиях и так далее. Сколько лет можно соревноваться? Ну сколько? Ну посоревнуйтесь в юморе, посоревнуйтесь в вкладе в науку. Это хорошие соревнования. И у России есть чем гордиться. Один только Михаил Ломоносов чего стоит, и все остальные за ним. Я уж не говорю про Мандельштама, имеется в виду вклад в литературу, которого случайно расстреляли. Ну или там вот, сегодня только читал, как его фамилия была? Такой известный физик, теоретик, космолог. Космолог, в 30-е годы быть космологом. Который с Ландау работал, был один из них, их мушкетеров. Как его фамилию забыл, блин? Ну, тоже копнули в 37-м нечаянно. Ну, по ошибке, это не наша вина. Ну, не наша это вина. Но были ошибки, был перелом. Переломали не тех, не слишком сильно. Ну, ладно, короче, вы все так поняли.